I grew up four doors from Lil Armstrong. And growing up, I had really no idea the importance and significance of Lil Armstrong. I had no idea she had been married to Louis Armstrong. I just knew her as Mrs. Armstrong. And I guess I met her when I had cognizance of her was about 8 years old. I think my first experience with Lil Armstrong was I ran out in front of the street at 8 years old and just barely missed being hit by a car, and she came out and got me. And I always remembered her as Mrs. Armstrong. And then I had turned 21 and I was going to Roosevelt University, getting ready to take finals that year, and I was a senior. And Red Saunders called me up and said, "Man, you want to go on the road for a couple of weeks with a band?" I said, "Red, no, I can't, man. I'm in school." He said, "It's with Duke Ellington." I said, "What time the bus leave?" And waiting to be picked up by a cab to join the band, to go down here to Central Station, because they were playing in at one of the colleges. I forgot quite now. But she came out and she said, "Tell Duke, Lil Armstrong said hello." And I was like taken back that she sounded so familiar with Duke Ellington. And then from then on, I really realized who Lil Armstrong was. And then the next significant thing experience I had with Lil was that I was playing with Red Saunders here under the Picasso when she died. I was, matter of fact, sitting next to her. And that was quite something, because the significance of that was that she died playing, as you know. And they called for a medical person, and when he turned her over, I never forget that, he said, "I'll be damned, she's smiling." She had this big, she was pronounced dead, but had this big smile on her face. And I thought, you know, I think I'm just going to continue to play music. If that's the way you can end this, then I'm gonna try harder to be better at this craft. Yeah.